What up, guys? This is Casey is raw again, and today I'm finally getting out of the house and out from at the work. Trying to stay out of the snow. It's just above freezing, or at freezing right now. But I feel not that bad, though, but I had to get out of the house. I mean, I've been cooped up in the house all the last couple weeks. I didn't even travel that much at all, so I had to get out. And, I had to get my booster and my new card because when you go to WrestleMania, not only you had to be, I guess you had to be up with all your shots. I believe you had to show your card, too. So, I'm like, I needed to get my booster anyways. So, it'd be cool. I mean, my job gave me $500 just for a shot. For the shots. And I already got them before that, so I was okay with that. And what was weird, that a lot of people were pissed off about. Like, hold on. And like, they didn't... Whoa, nice house they're building over there. A freaking mansion. Someone's rich. I saw something at the corner of my eye. Oh, yeah, back what I was talking about. Yes, people got upset. My job saying, to get paid, you have to get shots. It's not mandatory. They just give you an initiative or a bonus if you got your shots. So, I didn't see the big deal. Like I said, it's not like they said you had to have your shots mandated or mandatory. So, then I can understand being upset, getting free money for some shot that you get free. But that's beside the point. I'm just glad to get out. It's been brutal out here the last few days. Because it snowed and have ice everywhere. Like right now, my driveway, it's up like that. So I had to gun it in just to get up the driveway. But like the main roads are fine. They're just perfectly fine. Actually, why am I going to take the turnpike when I can get there just as fast? I'm actually going to get out of this lane and get in the other lane. Because I was planning to go to the game store. Just got a little mixed up for a second, but I'm good. Yeah, heading to the game store, then the vintage dock, and maybe the vintage dock out further. And then we'll see. It's only 12:30. I got up super early today. Well, for me, on the weekend, just before 9, I woke up. That was super early for me. But I slept a ton. Dude, I slept... I mean, my mom said she saw me passed out on the couch. And it was 10 o'clock. And I know I was I fell asleep during watching SmackDown. I mean, I enjoyed the beginning of SmackDown. It was real good. And then I remember it was the tag team was Humberto and the other dude, the lover the Latino Lover tag team, whatever they call themselves, versus, I don't even remember who they fought, but then I also remember when Sami Zayn was out there saying, anyone wants to fight for the Intercontinental title, get it. And I'm just like, I knew it. I was going to, from all the rumors, it was like, I'm going to hear that Jackass theme song. And it played it. I'm okay for Johnny Knoxville going for the Intercontinental title. I mean, it, and I think it'll be interesting. I know some people are going to be upset when I'm going to say this, but, one, you know he's going to flip out just when Knoxville wins the Intercontinental title. And I think they got to. Because, one, it would give Sami Zayn another reason to freak out and have a conspiracy theory again. But, Yeah, I think that's cool. I know a lot of people don't like that, and I usually don't, but you know that Knoxville will take bumps. Moves, I don't know what he's going to be doing, and I'm going to bet money that if it's a hardcore match, I don't know what they're going to do. Maybe a no disqualification, and then like the group of Jackass jumps him, jumps Sammy, and then Knoxville wins the Intercontinental title. That's the best way I think to do it. You don't want him to actually have a weapon, especially when wrestlers knows how to use these weapons in a safe way so they don't actually hurt their opponents. I mean, and I'm pretty sure Knoxville's okay getting hit with stuff. I mean, he loved doing stunts. That's why, like, during Action, was it Action Park? I believe that's what it's called. He got a ton of injuries because he wanted his own, do most of his own stunts. And that doesn't shock me. He's crazy like that. You figure with all those injuries that he would not want to do that no more. I guarantee you, he said he had to have a catheter for like years because of one bit. You figure you wouldn't want to do anything if you had to have a catheter in you for years. And then you get concussions and all type of bone breaks. Screw that shit. I mean, yeah, he's making millions and millions of dollars, but he's already done movies like, was it Men in Black 2? That's the only one I really know him in. But be interesting. I can't wait to get out there. Hopefully I get something good today. It's just been very cold out there. It's been very thin out there lately. I really had. I mean, last weekend they had a vintage stock was doing buy two, get one free sale. Went to like three vintage stocks. I didn't find enough to warrant to buy any of them. And a lot of it just seems worse. It's like, by the time I get out of work to try to do it, all the good shit is gone. But it's okay. I've been enjoying doing, like, the Atari games and the ColecoVision games. You know what's funny? it's made from Coleco. So isn't it technically Coleco, ColecoVision? That's like calling, let's say if Nintendo went that way, the Nintendo Vision. Oh gosh, I'm seeing a McDonald's sign. Yesterday I got out of work, the weather was still pretty bad, I didn't want to go back out. So I had a DoorDash, and this is the third time I ever used it. And this time the person fucked up and took it to the wrong door. I went to, he said it was delivered. As I went to check my front door, it's like, oh no, someone already stole it? Then I was like, maybe it's at the other door. Then I looked at the picture, it's like, hold on, that's not even this house. So I messaged the guy, it's like, dude, that's not my house. And I don't know. And then he asked me, is it right order? I'm like, I don't know. I was going to say, can't tell you if it's right yet, but I was like, dude, if I tell them that if the order is wrong, that then that's McDonald's fault, not yours. And I wasn't going to be an asshole and say this guy sent it to the wrong house, because the guy went back and got it delivered to me. So I wasn't going to give him a bad review because he made a mistake. I was going to probably give him good review on it, because he did. The only thing is weird, that he opened the bag. I'm like, why does he need to open? Unless he didn't, the person who picked it up, open it up. But I don't know why he would open it. But it's not a big deal. I was kind of a little worried, like, is this guy gonna drop some poison in it? Well, and if I would died, well, at least they would know who did it. What the fuck you doing, pal? Move. You read me. Well, I'm pretty much at the game store. Holy shoot, it's like slush. It's just, like I said, it's just above freezing, and it's just snow, slush, and ice everywhere. Well, I'm gonna park right over here. I usually would park right here, but I don't want to be the... I'm like, hey, dickhead, that's not a parking spot. I mean, believe me, I'm not the first person parked like that, but... I'll be right back. Well, guys, just got, not only got out of vintage stock, I just got... Well, not only out of the video game store, got out of vintage stock. And... well, the video game store might have had some stuff. It was... It was so crowded. I couldn't really get a good look at anywhere. So... called Scotty. I know he might be still working right now, so, I might have an idea. And I'm kind of regretting the socks that I choose. I'm wearing those mini socks, and apparently there's so many that they barely could reach the top of my heel, and now they scrunch down, so I probably will stop somewhere and get, instead of go all the way home, just get a cheap pair of socks somewhere. But, yeah, try to call Scotty. I might call him in a few again. you asshole. Damn it. Alright, I can get out now. It was weird because the other lanes were turning, and then for some reason the next intersection turned and it started going forward. Like, what the hell? Usually you have the turns and then you have the people right after that goes forward. They didn't do that, so that was weird. I'm actually at the area that I got pulled over during 45 in the school zone, because when it's, or was it 35, because I didn't know, one, I didn't know the school zone, two, I was driving the speed limit. It was to the point where I guess I had a high enough ticket or a high enough violation. I had to go to court for that one. I'll be right back. And I'm back, guys. Sorry about that. I got a call on Skype, so I wanted to take it. So I'm about to hit one of the further vintage dogs. Probably had nothing. I just hadn't got lucky in a while. So, after this, I'm going to see Scott a call. Actually, I probably, when I get to this one, give Scott a call and see if we want to travel. If not, that's fine. I kind of want to get out. I was about to pick up a bunch of Super Famicom games, but I'm like, it looked like a bunch of sports games. Like, and then I think I got most of the cool, or like the rare games that for the Super Nintendo, for the Japanese versions that I picked up. Like, you know, even though I got Secret of Mana already, I picked up the Japanese one first, I believe. Then I finally picked up Secret of Mana. I actually need to play that for you guys. Give it a shot. But, I'm at the next vintage stock. I'm going to give Scotty a call. It's not a play by ear. I don't know yet. We'll see.